Let us start yoga sadhana with yogic sukshma vyayam or loosening practices to increase microcirculation. Neck movements. Forward and backward neck bending.
Caution. Avoid this practice in case of severe cervical spondylitis.
Start with alert posture. Samasthiti. Stand with the feet 2 to 3 inches apart. Keep the hands on the waist. While exhaling, move the head forward slowly and try to touch the chest with the chin. While inhaling, move the head backwards in a comfortable way. This is one round. Repeat one more round. Right and left neck bending.
Caution, do not overstrain during practice.
While exhaling, bend the head slowly to the right. Experience stretching on the left side. While inhaling, bring the head to the center position. While exhaling, bend the head to the left side. Experience stretching on the right side. Inhale and bring the head to the center position. This is one round. Repeat one more round. Right and left neck twisting.
Caution, do not give jerk to the neck.
Keep the head straight. While exhaling, gently turn the head to the right so that the chin is in line with the shoulder. While inhaling, bring the head to the center position. While exhaling, turn the head to the left. Feel or experience stretching on the right side. Inhale and bring the head to the center position. This is one round. Repeat one more round. Neck rotation.
Caution. People with neck pain and cervical spondylosis do this practice carefully.
Exhale. Bend the head forward, trying to touch the chest with the chin. Inhale. Slowly rotate the head clockwise in a circular motion. Exhale while coming down. This is one round. Repeat one more round. Then rotate the head in an anti-clockwise direction. Inhale, go back, exhale, and come down. This is one round. Repeat one more round. Relax. Shoulder movements. Shoulders and arms movement.
Caution. Frozen shoulder patients do this practice carefully.
Start with alert posture. Samasthiti. Keep the fingers together, pointing downwards. While inhaling, move both the arms from side above the head with the palm facing outward. Exhale and bring them down. This is one round. Repeat one more round. Shoulder rotation. Stand straight Inhale and raise both the arms up to shoulder level and bend them in from the elbows. Place the fingers on the respective shoulders. Try to touch the elbows in front of the chest. Rotate both the elbows and shoulders in a circular manner. This is one round. Repeat one more round. Do the same in reverse manner two times. Inhale while raising the arms and exhale while bringing them down. Bring the arms down and relax. Trunk movement. Trunk twisting.
Caution. In case of vertebral disorders, do this practice under the guidance.
Starting from the alert posture, raise both the arms up to the chest level, keeping the palms facing each other and the arms parallel to each other. Keep the feet about 1 foot apart. While exhaling, twist the body towards the right side. Come back with inhalation. While exhaling, rotate the trunk and spine towards the left side. Come back with inhalation. This is one round. Repeat one more round. Slowly return the arms with exhalation and feet together. Relax. Knee movement.
Caution. In case of arthritis
and obesity,
do this practice carefully.
Start in alert posture. Then keep the feet 1 foot apart. Inhale. Move your arms up to the shoulder level from the front, palms facing downwards. Exhale. Bend the knees and bring down your body to the half squatting position. In the final position, both the arms and thighs should remain parallel to the ground. Come back with inhalation. This is one round. Repeat one more round. Slowly return the arms with exhalation and bring the feet together. Relax. Now, let us move towards Yogasana. Standing postures. Tadasana or the palm tree posture. Caution. Avoid lifting the heels in case of arthritis, varicose veins and vertigo. Starting from alert posture, assume standing position. Keep your feet 2 inches apart. Inhale. Lift your arms up to the shoulder level from the front. Interlock the fingers. Exhale. Turn the palms outward. Now, inhale. Stretch the arms over your head. Raise the heels off the floor and balance on the toes. Maintain the final position for 3 to 10 breaths with body awareness. Bring the heels down. Release the interlock of the fingers. Exhale. Bring the arms down by the sides and come back to starting posture. Vrikshasana or the tree posture. Caution. Avoid this practice in case of arthritis, vertigo and obesity. Starting from alert posture,
Focus on a point in front. Exhale. Move the right leg up and place the foot on the inner side of the left thigh. The heel should be touching the perineum. Inhale and extend the arms up and join the palms together in Namaskar Mudra. Maintain the final position for 3 to 10 breaths with body awareness. Exhale. Bring the arms down. Release the right leg and bring it to the starting position. Repeat on the other side. Exhale. Move the left leg up and place the foot on the inner side of the right thigh. The heel should be touching the perineum. Inhale and extend the arms up and join the palms together in Namaskar Mudra. Maintain the final position for 3 to 10 breaths with body awareness. Exhale. Bring the arms down. Release the left leg and bring it to the starting position. Padhastasana or the hands to the feet posture. Caution. Please avoid this practice in case of cardiac spinal disorders and glaucoma. From the starting posture, assume standing position with feet 2 inches apart. Inhale slowly and raise the arms upwards from the front. Stretch up the body from the waist. Exhale and bend forward at the level of hip joints until both the palms rest fully on the ground. Stretch the back to make it as straight as possible. Maintain the final position for 3 to 10 breaths with body awareness. Now inhale. Come up slowly to the upright position and stretch the arms above the head. Exhale. Slowly bring down the arms and return to the starting position. Ardhachakrasana or the half wheel posture. Caution. Avoid this posture in case of vertigo and in cardiac problems. Starting from alert posture, stand with feet 2 inches apart. Support the back at the sides of the waist with the fingers. Try to keep the elbows parallel to each other. Drop the head backwards, stretching the front side of the neck. As you exhale, bend backwards from the lumbar region. Maintain the final position for 3 to 10 breaths with body awareness. Inhale and slowly come up and return to the starting position. Relax. Trikonasana or the triangle posture. Caution. Avoid this posture in case of slipped disc, sciatica, and after abdominal surgery. From the alert posture, spread out the feet 3 feet apart. Inhale. Raise both the arms from the side up to the shoulder level and palms facing outwards. Turn the right foot towards right side. Exhale. Slowly bend to the right side and place the right hand just behind the right foot. The left arm is straight in line with the right arm. Turn your head and gaze at the tip of the left middle finger. Maintain the final position for 3 to 10 breaths with body awareness. Inhale. Slowly come up and bring the right foot back. Repeat on the other side. Turn the left foot towards left side.
Exhale. Slowly bend to the left side and place the left hand just behind the left foot. Turn your head and gaze at the tip of the right middle finger. The right arm is straight in line of the left arm. Maintain the final position for 3 to 10 breaths with body awareness. Inhale. Slowly come up. And bring the left foot back. Exhale. Bring the arms down and feet together. Come to the starting position and relax. Sitting postures. Bhadrasana or the firm posture. Caution. Avoid this practice in case